aircraft carriers and the planes against China, but we use what we call the anti-access area denial strategy. Swarm tactics using missile boats, frigates, missile-capable small boats, and land-based missiles. Ito ang idea ng marami, including myself. Second-hand frigates, so they can be immediately deployed. We don't have to wait 3 years. Small missile boats, like the one that Iran is using against the U.S. fleet in the Persian Gulf, and the Hayabusa missile boats, and of course, land-based missiles. Unfortunately, yung pagbili ng second-hand frigate was canceled, and instead, the government is going to order brand new, pero hindi pa nag-bid out ito. And it's going to take 3-4 years, plus it's more expensive. This one, dapat nung 2013 pa, nasa atin na ito. But for some reason, this was canceled. Ito yung Maestrale. May pwede tayong bumili ng mga second-hand F-15s or F-16s, but instead, we bought FA-50 from Korea, 12 of them, costing about 18 billion pesos. And the no less than the incumbent National Security Advisor in a Senate hearing said, the South China Sea Road is the biggest security threat for the Philippines. So, ang sabihin, kailangan natin ng defense dyan. Pero nangyari, kinansel yung shore-based missile system natin, and instead, the government, the AFP decided to order helmets and vests. At kailangan natin missile eh. Why do we need missiles? To protect our shores, our seas. At pag meron tayong missile, if you are a commander of a frigate or a destroyer out there, you're going to be worried about these shore-based missiles like this. Okay, namasalubong mo doon. Instead of helmets. Sinabi natin yung missile, parang sa Tagalog, isang bala ka lang. Kahit anong laki mo, isang bala ka lang. Kahit anong laki ng bapor mo, isang missile ka lang. And it's cheaper to buy missiles than buy frigates. The Philippines are aware of the serious situation in the disputed area. From the palace. Of course, merong China's economic upheaval. Their stock market went down by 40%. They lost something like $4 trillion. But this economic upheaval presents both opportunity and risk. It can be a very complex security situation for us because, you know, a wounded tiger can either withdraw deeper into the jungle or attack. If they can, in tawag ito, they can wag the dog instead of wagging the tail. They can wag the dog so that the people, the domestic people, will forget about their domestic problems. What are the most recent developments? Ito, umiigting yung tension doon. The American military commander issued a very strong statement about China's claims in the South China Sea. U.S. Admiral signals wider role for the third fleet. The third fleet is based in the West Coast. Now they want the third fleet to come closer and combine with the seventh fleet. Admiral, blunt warning over Chinese maritime expansion. This is the Pacific Fleet Admiral. He delivered a speech in Australia. So, pataas, painit ng painit yung mga statement. Navy will challenge Chinese territorial claims in South China Sea. Ito ang the latest development. Because the Navy now, the U.S. Navy is preparing to send a surface ship inside the 12 nautical mile territorial limit of the reclamation areas of China. Papasokin lang nila ito, they will maneuver in the South China Sea, well within the 12 nautical mile zone of these islands, these artificial islands. So when that happens, what will we do? So my recommendation is this. My recommendation, because this is a matter of grave security. We don't know what's going to happen. So my recommendation is to convene the executive committee of the National Security Council. And who are the members of the Executive Committee? Medyo ayaw yata ng palasyo na mag-convene ng bigger, the big National Security Council, where there will be a lot of politicians. So it would be limited to the President, the Vice President, Senate President, Speaker of the House, Executive Secretary, the National Security Advisor, and then the Secretaries of Foreign Affairs, Justice, National Defense, Interior, Local Government, and other members. And I think this is necessary because we have to, first, the political leaders must know what is happening, what would happen. And they must, the group must assess, must brainstorm the possible implications of the U.S. Navy entering the area. What are the possible scenarios? First, the first question is, will the U.S. really send their warships and aircraft within 12 nautical miles of the reclaimed reef? That is their announcement. The question is, will they really do that? We don't know, because President Obama is known to be a peacenik, no? And the military and the Pentagon want that they go in, but President Obama is still thinking about it. And if they do, what would be the most likely response of China? Would China just sit down and say, well, it's a more powerful country? But then, of course, they're closer to the point of conflict. They have aircraft, they have ships there. Are they going to use that? If that happens, that is going to result in a very tense face-off and showdown of the two top military powers of the world, with all its frightening implications. And what should be the reaction of the Philippines before they announce the entry in force of the U.S. Navy? What should be our reaction? Should we just remain quiet because we say, well, this is the play of superpowers. We will just have to watch. Well, the U.S. deploying and building up their forces in the South China Sea, how should we assist our treaty ally? Should we allow the U.S. use of our military bases?
It's already
if we do, there will be some implications also, because the use of our bases by the U.S. military may be considered a hostile act by China. And how would China react to us in the short term and in the long run? What about if there's already a face-off? What statement should we make? Should we just be the peacekeeper? Or should we be express sympathy and support to the United States? How should the AFP, particularly the Philippine Navy, even the Air Force, prepare for the various contingencies? There will be, there must be contingencies, because anything can happen. You know, this is not, I'm not talking as an alarmist, I'm talking as a rational man who understands military moves. When two big powers face off, anything can happen. Maybe they'll just look at each other, they wave at each other, but there can be miscalculation. And a miscalculation can result in an actual physical conflict that will have a very big impact on our security. And it is something that that is going to happen whether we like it or not. I'd like to stress, the U.S. will go in, not to support us. The U.S. will go in because it is in their national interest, because they don't want to be elbowed out of the South China Sea. And if there is, God forbid, no, an actual shooting confrontation, what role should the Philippines take to protect our national interest? Should we allow the U.S. combat assets, access to our bases? Of course, it goes without saying that if there would be casualties from all sides, we should make available our medical facilities, because we are the closest. We are within 1 hour flying in case of an emergency medical evacuation. And I believe there should be a methodical assessment of the likelihood of the above scenarios. Hindi pwedeng isang special group lang ito. Hindi pwedeng nag-iisip lang isang tao in the corner, no? Dapat i-brainstorm ito ng mga experts in a very rational way, so the Philippines and other affected countries can properly prepare. The time could be very short. What the announcement says is that within 2 weeks it will happen. Within 2 weeks, the security situation in the South China Sea might change very radically. And one final note, ito yung sinasabi ko kanina, yung political interference. This is a book, 100 Year Marathon, written by an expert, Pillsbury. He's a student of China. He used to be very supportive of China because he thought that an economically stronger China would be a more gentle China.